Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to get the most from Safari on your Mac by using the Favorites bar. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the Favorites bar is one of the best parts of Safari. Yet a lot of people don't even use it. Let me show you some of the ways it can make you more productive when browsing using Safari. So to show the Favorites bar, you can go to View and Show Favorites Bar. The keyboard shortcut is Shift-Command-B. So if you want to quickly bring it up and hide it again, it's important to learn that shortcut. When you bring up the Favorites bar, you get a list of links here at the top. Now these links are actually in your bookmarks. If you look under Bookmarks, you'll see Favorites, and the list of favorites here is the same as the list of favorites you see in the Favorites bar. So the idea is to put your most important websites in the Favorites folder in your bookmarks. That way they'll appear in Bookmarks, but also here in the Favorites bar and other places as well. Using it is pretty simple. If you want to go to a website, just click the link there and it will load up that web page in your current browser tab. Adding a page to the Favorites bar is easy to do as well. When you're at a page you want to add, you can drag it from the address field here right into the Favorites bar. And then it immediately takes you into the editing mode where you can edit the name. So you want to shorten the name in most cases. You can also just use Bookmarks, Add Bookmark, or the keyboard shortcut Command D. And then when you're adding, make sure you set it to add to your Favorites folder in Bookmarks. Now you can edit your favorites by going into Bookmarks and then Edit Bookmarks. And this allows you to edit all of your bookmarks, including the Favorites folder. So you can click the reveal arrow here, open it up, and you can see all of your bookmarks. You can select one, you can hit the delete key to delete it, you can click to select and then click again to edit the name, or click here to edit the address. You can rearrange the bookmarks by clicking and dragging, but you can do the same thing right in the bookmarks bar. You can click and drag down, and when you go far enough down and release, it will delete it. You could also click and hold and you could rename it. You could rearrange them in the bookmarks bar by clicking and dragging left or right. Now you could also control click or two finger click on a trackpad or right click on a mouse, and you get options here. For instance, there's rename and there's edit address. So you can edit the address right here in the bookmarks bar. You can also copy the address or delete it using the context menu. And instead of opening this link in the current tab, you can open it in a new tab or open it in a new window. Now a very powerful part of the bookmarks bar is the fact that you can have folders in it as well. Here we could see I've got a news folder and a popular folder. These are part of the default set. So if you click here, you could see you get a drop down menu with several bookmarks in it. So instead of taking up space for each one of these things in the bookmarks bar, it's just one little folder, and then you can choose which link you want to go to. If you go to Edit Bookmarks, you could see these folders in here, and you can work with them here to move items in or out of them or rearrange the items in them. Creating a new folder can be done by selecting Favorites here and then go to Bookmarks, Add Bookmark Folder, or Control Click and New Folder. You can also select a folder and do New Folder, and it'll create a subfolder inside it. So I can create, say, a local news folder inside of my news folder. Now when I click here, you can see I've got a subfolder, and I can create several levels of bookmarks easily accessible through the Favorites bar. Also note that when you have a folder, you can click it and then choose Open in New Tabs. And this will open all of the bookmarks inside this folder in separate tabs. But here's a really cool feature. You can control click and then turn on Automatically Replace Tabs. With that on, you get a little square next to the name here. And what happens when you click that is it replaces all the tabs you currently have open in this window with tabs for each website in here. So for instance, say I have these three tabs open here. If now I click this, these three tabs will be completely replaced by all of the sites that are in this folder. And I could turn this off by unchecking it. You also have the ability when you control click to sort by, and you can sort all of the items in this folder by name or address. Now you can do a ton of different things with modifier keys. How the modifier keys work with these links and folders in the favorites bar depends on your settings in Safari, preferences, and then tabs. So here I have it set to command click opens a link in a new tab. So normally if I were to click here it would open up this link in the current tab. But if instead I command click, you can see just like my setting there, it opens it up in a new tab. And if I shift command click, it opens up in a new tab and brings that tab to the front. Now if you hold the shift key down, what will happen is it opens up the link in a new window. So shift, click, and you can see I've got a new window here now with that link. Now in addition to shift clicking opening up a new window, it will also obey the rule that's here. In this case, command option click opens up in a new window too, or command option shift click opens it up in a new window and brings the window to the front. So command option click will open this new window. You won't see it, but now there is a second window behind this first one with that link. If I shift command option and then click, it will do the same thing, but now that's the front window. Option does something very different. It will download the web page. So if I option click, you can see it quickly downloaded that page. And you can see here it's listed in downloads. Now it'll only make sense if there's something there to download. But let's say you've got a report for work that's a PDF and it's always at the same link. You could add it to your favorites bar and then option click it. It'll automatically download the current version of that file to your downloads folder. Now if you don't want to set a folder here to always replace all the tabs, you can leave it as a normal folder where you can select each individual item. But then option click the folder and it will replace all the tabs. Interestingly, when you do this, if you use the back button, it goes back in all of the tabs. So you go back to where you were. You can also use command click on a folder and it will add all of those web pages to the tabs while keeping the ones you currently have open. Here's one last tip I want to show you. People often say they want to have the little icon for the website here in the favorites bar. Well, there's no way to bring that up, but you can add emoji. So for instance, see this news folder here? I'm going to control click on it and rename it. And I'm going to put a little newspaper emoji just before news. So control command space brings up the emoji in special character viewer. I'll search for news and there are a couple of newspaper icons to choose from. I'll select this one, put a space there, and now I have a little newspaper icon. Maybe for this link to the Apple website, I'll rename that one and add a little apple to it right there. So you can really add some color to your bookmarks bar. Or perhaps you can just use the emojis if you want. So for instance, you can take away the text there completely and just have a little emoji for this folder, or just an apple for a link to the Apple site. So as you can see, there's a lot of functionality in the favorites bar in Safari. I often tell people who keep a lot of tabs open to use the bookmarks bar instead. Put all of your most important sites there and it's easy to be able to click it to open it up in a new tab or replace the current tab with a link that's there. You don't need to keep that website open in a tab because it's so easy to get back to it if you have it in your favorites bar. And by using folders, instead of being limited to maybe a dozen links in the favorites bar, you could have hundreds inside of folders and subfolders organized and arranged in a way that works best for you. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.